Good evening. I'm Jeanne Tucci, and this is the County Connection. It's a program about county government with members of county government, and sometimes we stray from the basics. But this evening, I have with me County Controller Sandy Graffius, who has brought a friend, and she's going to be introducing that friend right now.
And I got to tell you, I'm a real strayer. I stray to nonprofits and anybody else in the community that I think needs to be known about and needs publicity. And tonight, it is your turn. June is from the Community Foundation organization, and she had, she gave me questions, which cracks me up because I'm going to forget to look at them. Anyway, she is part of a program called Jumpstart, and you're pretty new to the program. How new are you?
I will be just coming up to a year.
I need
about
to have a cake.
2 weeks. Oh, I don't know about that.
I think they should have a cake. Now, before you were Jumpstart guru.
Yes, before I was the director of the Jumpstart Incubator.
That's the one.
That's the question? Okay.
You're really designated there, aren't you?
I have been all my career an accountant. So I've been a CFO, a controller, vice president of finance in a few different organizations.
You're a pencil pusher.
I am a pencil pusher.
And proud of it.
Counter, whatever other nickname you want to come up with.
That's great. So your background is finance.
Exactly.
And so when Kevin Murphy asked you to come in there, he knew that you had already an organizational background as far as getting things off the ground.
Right, exactly.
Am I right on
exactly,
target?
Yes. Okay. And my experience has most of the time been with smaller businesses, so I understand that part of it. I'm not used to the big corporate, 15 departments and 2,000 people.
Like the county.
Right. And also, Ed and I, my husband and I, started a business several years ago, too. So I've kind of been I've been through that idea of starting from scratch.
Are you still running it?
Yep. Well, I'm not in it anymore, but...
Did you run out of time? before you ran out of things to do.
Yeah, I just got too busy.
Okay, let's start with the fact that you have an accounting background.
Okay.
Kevin said, you want to do the Jumpstart program? And you said, what? And he said, this is the way it works.
Right. So the incubator is a collaboration that was started about almost 4 years ago now, between the Berks County Community Foundation and the Kutztown Small Business Development Center. So they put their heads together and said, what can we bring to downtown Reading that will help economic development? Let's help small businesses get started. So
how small? Avon Ladies?
It probably should be a little bit more than that, and especially because of the type of business that is. But really, there is no size limits. When I say small, it's typically 1-2-person operation that is getting started.
Are you more gearing toward service organizations or toward manufacturing?
I would definitely say service organizations. Okay. or organizations that are selling items, retail, wholesale, that
rather
type
than
of
manufacturing
thing. We don't have the facility for manufacturing, so that tends to limit us that way. We have office space, but we don't have big space that most manufacturers are looking for, right?
When you have your office space, do you encourage the people that you're working with to come and set up an office in your building?
Yes. Mm-hmm. That is the main goal, is to get them into this specific area. We've got 8 offices up on the 3rd floor of the foundation building.
Okay. And then they come into you, mm-hmm. and you say, you put your arm around them. Let me tell you what I can do for you.
Right.
Come upstairs. This is your chair. This is your desk. This is your computer. Please sit down and I will tell you what to do.
Right.
How am I doing?
Well, you're doing pretty well. what we try to do is guide them. and coach them. I'm not going to exactly tell them what to do. It is their business, and they need to figure it out.
Well, but let's start with somebody walking through the door.
Yep.
And they say to you, I want to help people work their way through an insurance program for medical benefits.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now they have no background. Do you then provide training as far as getting them into the correct courses to learn what they have to do, or don't you go back that far?
I don't go back that far. Okay. Typically, when people come to me, it's because they already have a passion, an idea that they want to make a reality.
Okay.
So either they're just in the beginning startup stage and they're not really sure what direction to go in, but they know that this is what they want to do. But a lot of times what I'm doing is I'm talking to people who have had a business for a year or two and they've been working out of their home.
Oh,
and
really?
Now they realize, you know what, I need to step up a little bit in order to grow this business. Working out of my home is not really the best. So now I have these professional offices in a beautiful building that I can have you come in.
Yeah.
There's a parking garage across the street. There's
parking right alongside.
Well, that's owned by the church.
Oh, is it?
So you get a parking permit and you can park there, yes.
Okay, but you can park across the street right there at 3rd and...
Yeah. Right.
Are you at
3rd and Court?
Yeah.
3rd and Court, right. Mm-hmm.
Okay, now they come into you and they say, okay, I want to get more professional. I want to get more growth. I want to have some idea of what to do here.
Mm-hmm.
And you say, okay, I'll give you office space. Then what do you give them?
And then I also, what we really do is we try to educate them on the components of what they need to run a business. So my background is accounting. The very first thing I'm going to do is make sure that they've got their bookkeeping kind of in order and that they actually can produce financial statements for their business.
The first question you ask is, do you have a business plan?
Yes. Well, that too. So we can work with them on that. We can work with them on a marketing plan. You know, a lot of times somebody has this passion. Let's say, you know, they're a great baker, so they want to start making something that they're going to be selling at the farmer's market and so on.
Cupcakes.
Yeah, exactly. But they have no idea what did they have to do. Well, that you need to open a business checking account. We make sure that you get that set up, and then you need to keep track of the money coming in and going out. That's what bookkeeping is. So we make sure you've got something set up to do that.
Are you doing all this on a one-to-one? Are you doing classes?
We absolutely do it one-to-one.
Okay.
So that I can tell you for your specific business and your specific circumstances what you need to do.
Yeah.
Now, we do have some group sessions where we bring all the clients together, because there's certain things that we need to communicate really to all of them, and we can do that in that type of format.
How do they hear about you?
We do have a website, which is www.jumpstartberks.org, and so some people find it that way. Some people find it because I come on to BCTV and talk to you fine folks, and they think about it at that point, or I'm in the Reading Eagle or something like that, and there's an article about the incubator, and then that gets people coming.
Do you ever do programs for the chamber?
At this point, that has not happened.
Okay.
But
I'm sure you're prepared to do that, Ellen Herman. Is that correct?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. You know, Ellen and the chamber have so many resources because they have, you know, what, 1,500 different company members. They have experts in every field.
Yeah.
So they usually have people they can draw from, but I'd be more than happy to do that.
The thing is, what you're working with are really small people just getting started.
That, for the most part,
you know,
that's exactly right.
You're not working with established businesses
that
need to have a mentor come in and say, this is how you go ahead and get bigger. This is how you see what your market niche is.
Right. We're talking about very small businesses.
And what do you have right now?
We have 4 clients, but just today I talked to 3 new ones, and in the next month they'll all be signed up. It just happened like that.
And what do the 4 do that you have right now? What are they trying to accomplish? What are they trying to sell?
It really varies a lot, and you know, I'm thinking that I want to talk a little bit more in general terms about clients, just because of the confidentiality. But there are clients that are selling services, providing services, selling
when they
apparel.
When they provide services, are they providing, I don't know what you call the Merry Maids that go out and clean, or are they doing more sophisticated stuff than that?
Well, the one company I'm happy to talk about to some level, and they're doing more technology-based things. So web and computer programming.
They're coming with a skill.
Oh, absolutely. They have the skill. I mean, I am not going to tell them how to do their business from the standpoint of what it is they're selling, because honestly, the guys that what I'm talking about with the computer programming, I don't know anything about that.
Nor do you care.
But I do understand what it takes to hire an employee, or what, you know, what type of marketing things they need to consider.
What kind of human resources things they have to have.
Exactly, exactly. Because if you think about it, a business has, you know, basic components. You have your accounting finance piece of it, you have your human resource piece of it, you have your operations piece of it. Now, all of those things change to some degree depending on the type of business, but those components have to be there all the time.
Are you, Jeanne, stretching yourself to learn things you didn't learn before?
Absolutely. And I always want to do that. I always want to do that. I don't want to ever be in a situation where I'm not learning anything.
And so, as a result, in order to help these people, are you doing research? Are you doing...
You know how I'm changing, honestly, in this position, in this position, is being the person who's going out and talking about the incubator and having to be the spokesperson for a company. That's not a role I've ever had before. So for me, it's a whole new thing.
What, talking?
No.
My gosh, I'll
wrestle
you to the floor for
You can take lessons right there.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, I love to talk. And I try not to interrupt. I try to let you answer the question before I ask you another one.
No problem.
I think that's only fair that
yes.
I do that.
Yes, no problem.
Okay, now when your clients come in there and they're sitting in their office, do they meet each other?
Yes. Yes, that is where what we do is we try to have at least quarterly meetings where we bring all the clients together. And then we bring a speaker in with some expertise that a lot of the clients are asking for. And usually, even if someone isn't asking for that expertise, they usually can learn something.
Yeah, they probably don't know they need to know that.
Exactly.
The thing is, and I keep trying to figure out how to get this word out. Network, network, network.
Right.
And so if you bring your clients together, do they ever have services that they can buy from each other, or don't they interact that much?
Well, let's put it this way. That would be the ideal thing for us to be able to have that situation. But I don't want to control the people who are coming in to the point that, okay, right now I need an attorney. So unless you're an attorney, I'm not letting you in the incubator. I don't really want to set it up that way.
What's the best kind of business to come into you? Obviously small.
Yeah, I think that's the main thing. You know, again, really any type of business except for the manufacturing piece. And honestly, there are small manufacturers out there that I could work with on an off-site situation. So they wouldn't rent an office from me, but we have another program where I can work with a client who is not renting an office on our floor, but you know, I can go and visit with them and give them the support that they need.
You just said something very interesting. What are the expenses of the client to you?
Okay.
They pay rent, I've
That is exactly what it is. So we actually have three programs in place, and one of them is where they rent the office. So the rents range from about $200 a month to, for a two-office suite, $525 a month.
They can pick what they want?
Well, they have to see what's available. But okay. But other than that, yes, out of what's available, it's up to them. Because some of the offices fit one person, or two, or three. Or like I said, the two-office suite is a little bit different. So that includes utilities, it includes internet access, it includes office furniture that is very nice and already set up. It includes all of our coaching and support services. And the other thing I want to just mention is we actually also have graduate assistants that work for us.
Where do they come from?
They're from Kutztown University.
Oh, that's your tie into the university.
They're going to Kutztown for their MBAs. And so this gives them some real-world experience, and it allows them to work on projects that they can then also use for their classes.
When they pay you $200, do they decide how much you're going to pay, or is it by floor space?
It's by floor space.
So if they come into you and they say, look, we're just starting out, we hardly have any money, so I'll take the smallest space you have.
And that's certainly an option. And if the smallest space available is available, right now, those small offices tend to be the ones that
they grab
they
right
go
away.
First. But, you know.
And that's because they're all struggling to get started. They don't have $550 a month.
Right. And honestly, that's a high end. The average, I would say, is more in the 300 range, you know.
Yeah.
But if you think about the fact that it includes your utilities, you don't have to go out and buy office furniture because it's all a completely furnished office. You have access to the copier, internet access. You're not paying for internet access. You know, when you start putting all those pieces together, and then you talk about the coaching and the graduate assistant support,
I'm not debating your price.
Okay.
Maybe when I get out of office, I'll come run an office
because
it's a good deal.
I'd be happy to have you.
I'll start a business. I'll start a consulting business on speaking in public.
Okay.
Now, what are the graduates do? How often do they come?
So they put in 20 hours a week.
Oh, they have that much?
They put in 20 hours a week. It's part of the program, and Kutztown has, you know, a certain benefits that they give these students for being part of the program.
They get credit.
And they get credit towards their tuition, actually, is what they do.
Really?
Not credit for the class, but towards their tuition.
Huh.
Yeah.
So they're down there 20 hours a week. That's pretty good.
Yeah, so it gives us pretty good resources as having clients
be
able
to paying them.
Right.
Well, don't you have that worked out?
See, I told you I know about human resources.
Don't you just have that worked out?
You can tell there's a financier here.
There you go.
That's a bean counter background that says it for. How many come to you with their books set up?
None.
Really?
Well, let's put it this
way.
That
doesn't surprise me.
You know, you're the county controller too, so I have certain criteria. Like, you have to be able to produce a financial statement, and if you can't, it's because you don't have your book set up correctly.
Right.
Yeah.
So that's why I'm saying the answer is none of them do.
They might have a checkbook that shows how much they spent
and
how much they put into their company, and if they have sales or not.
Right.
And then that's it.
They almost all of them are set up to do their invoicing. And
Of
course they can take the deposits.
Well,
but it's
keeping
track of their expenses in some kind of format that actually tells them something.
Do you also help them file income taxes and stuff like that? You don't
get
into that.
No. But what I do is make sure that they are aware of CPAs in the area that do that sort of thing. But no, I'm not a tax expert. I can't do that.
Oh, I wasn't thinking of that. I was thinking of a simple 1040, but that's okay.
Let's put it this way, Sandy. I probably could do it, but that's not my role.
That's not
there.
Part of your...
No.
So your role is to have them walk in the door, say to you, I want to be more efficient. I want to be more businesslike. Come, I will show you different offices that are for rent, and then sit them down and say, okay, let's see what your books look like. Okay, I'm going to get you set up here so you can do a financial statement. Then what?
Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to sit down with them and I'm going to say, what goals do you have that you would like to get accomplished, and then let's talk about how that's going to happen and how we're going to
I want to put up on the screen before we go any further your contact information so that people know,
you know what,
how to get a hold of you.
Very good.
This is Jeanne Clouger, and
so it has my my email address, and it also has the phone number and the website. So please reach out to me if you have your own business and you're looking for.
I'm not done interrogating you. I just wanted to get that.
Thank you. I appreciate
you're
that.
Not, you're not near finished being tortured.
Oh, okay. All right. Thank you.
Okay. So now you do. So now you do the financial statement, and then you say to them, "What's your goal?"
Right.
Let's see how we're going to work toward that.
Right. You know, one of the things that small business owners really struggle with is that concept of strategic planning. You know, it's very easy to get involved in the day-to-day, okay, I have to make this widget or I have to go out and do this service. But, you know, sometimes you have to step back and say, all right, but what are my goals and what direction am I actually going in instead of just spinning the wheel?
Do you encourage them to make a budget, or if they have it, they spend it? If they don't, they don't?
Yeah, no, we will work with them to do a budget. We have spreadsheets, templates set up already to help them with projections, to do cash flow, to really understand what the numbers are that are.
Do you help them do a business plan to go to the bank to get financing?
Yes, we can.
Do you go with them?
No.
Okay.
And really the reason is because they are the owners of the business and they're the ones that really need to feel comfortable and be able to explain it to the bank. Because if I go, I'll end up explaining it.
Do you end up giving them a contact, or must they go around the banks themselves and find somebody to talk to?
We certainly will make recommendations as far as, you know, who they could possibly talk to. I mean, I have a lot of friends in banking, and I'm more than happy to recommend people. But it's still, they need to understand how to make these decisions.
You know, so many people have a dream of, they get downsized or right-sized or whatever the politically correct word is right now.
Right.
And they say, oh, wow, I'm going to start in business. How much money do you tell them to get ahead so that they can go ahead and support themselves until it goes on?
Yeah. You know, I think that what they need to do, and I've talked to some people who are in the situation, not so much that have been downsized, but that are thinking about it, and I say, if you're thinking about it and you're still working, just start putting your check aside and live on your spouse's money for a little
see
while.
See how it works
because
out.
Because that's what's going to happen for the first, you know, few months.
Well, I was in the funeral business in a former life, and they talked about 3 years to change your shopping habits to go from one big business to another big business.
Right.
And I think when you open another company, it takes you at least a year to build up a client base so that you can...
Right.
What didn't I ask you? We have 1 minute.
Oh, boy. You've asked me a lot. I think the main thing is for people to understand that if they are interested or are in a small business now and they're struggling a little bit or they're trying to figure out what direction to go in, that what they should do is just give me a call and we can have that one-on-one conversation and they can say, this looks good.
And you'll find out real quickly if what you have is what they need.
Exactly. Right. And if it's not, sometimes I know.
We've run out of time. I wish we had more.
Goodbye.
Come back sometime.
Goodbye, June.
Probably next
Thank
week
you.
Or the week after. I'll see you then. Good night. We'll be right back.